Thank you. Like to be seated, ladies and gentlemen. Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Sandy Hull, and I am a Deputy Superintendent Registrar for the County of Worcestershire. And it is my privilege and my pleasure to conduct this ceremony today. My friend and colleague, Eleanor Taylor, is the registrar, and Eleanor has the most important task of completing the legal schedule today. And on behalf of Eleanor and myself, I would like to welcome you all to Manor Hill House on this very special occasion of the marriage of David and Paula. You can take a seat. First of all, I have to tell you that this place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriage. One of the historic traditions involved in the wedding ceremony is the giving away of a loved one. Today, this act is seen as a symbol of support for her marriage and a promise of continued trust and affection from her family. Do you, John, give Paula to be married to David?
I do.
So you just take this hand, no, this hand here. I think they're holding hands now.
Hello.
And if you'd like to take a seat.
Thank you.
Cheers, John. You all right?
Yeah. David and Paula, today you will exchange vows which will unite you as husband and wife. The words are a formal and public pledge of your love and a promise of lifelong dedication to each other. However, if any person present knows of any lawful impediment to this marriage, he or she should declare it now. Well, that's a nice silence, isn't it? So, David, can you tell me your full names, please?
David Stephen Reed.
And Paula?
Paula Louise McKennedy.
Before you are joined in matrimony, it is my duty to remind you both of the solemn and binding character of the vows you are about to make. Marriage, according to the law of this country, is the union of two people. voluntarily entered into for life and to the exclusion of all others. I am now going to ask each of you in turn to declare that you do not know of any lawful reason why you should not be married to each other. Are you, David Stephen Reed, free lawfully to marry Paula Louise McKennedy?
Yes, I am.
Are you, Paula Louise McKennedy, free lawfully to marry David Stephen Reed?
I am.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, David and Paula have declared that they are indeed free to marry. So if you are able, please can you stand? David and Paula, you have gathered about you those whom you love. You invited them here to receive their encouragement and support and to celebrate with you at this special time. I ask you now, in the presence of this company, David, do you take Paula to be your wife? Do you promise to comfort her and love her? Rejoice with her through good times. Respect and cherish her. And David, do you promise to remain true to her for the rest of your lives together?
I do.
Paula, do you take David to be your husband? Do you promise to comfort him and love him? Rejoice with him through good times. Respect and cherish him. And Paula, do you promise to remain true to him for the rest of your lives together?
I do.
The moment has come for David and Paula to make their marriage contract with each other. So if you'd like to turn and face each other, like to hold hands. We're going to say these words to each other and not to myself. And these are the words that will make you man and wife. So David, can you repeat after me, please? I, David Stephen Reed.
I, David Stephen Reed.
Take you, Paula Louise McKennedy.
Take you, Paula Louise
McKennedy. To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And now you, Paula. I, Paula Louise McKennedy.
I, Paula Louise McKennedy.
Take you, David Stephen Reed.
Take you, David Stephen Reed.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
So if you'd like to be seated, ladies and gentlemen. For David and Paula, getting married today is a proud confirmation of the love, the respect and the true friendship that they have for each other. Together they will be stronger to meet whatever life holds for them. Through their vows they have made a commitment to each other for the rest of their lives. Marriage is not an easy path. It requires devotion, the ability to listen, the wisdom to know when we are wrong. David, that's you. And of course, the strength to put things right.
Last night.
We have now come to the exchange of the wedding rings, which is the traditional way of sealing the contract you have just made. The wedding ring is the unbroken circle, symbolising an ending and everlasting love, and is the outward sign of the lifelong promises you have made to each other. So, Alan, if you would give David Paula's ring. Stay there. If you were to place it on the third finger of Paula's left hand, holding it there, repeat after me. Paula, I give you this ring.
Paula, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
I promise to care for you.
I promise to care for you.
Love and honour you.
Love and honour you.
For as long as I live.
For as long as I live.
Place the ring on her finger.
There you go, sexy.
Okay, so Alan, may we have the groom's ring?
Thank you.
So Paula, take your groom's ring, place it on the tip of the third finger of David's left hand. Holding it there, repeat after me. David, I give you this ring.
David, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
I promise to care for you.
I promise to care for you.
Love and honour you.
Love and honour you.
For as long as I live.
For as long as I live.
And place the ring on his finger. David and Paula, you have both made the declarations prescribed by law, and you have made your own solemn promises to one another in the presence of your family and friends here today. Let the world recognise that you are husband and wife. May you treasure this trust and responsibility. May no failure or misfortune ever part you, and may you live rich and full lives together. It therefore gives me the greatest pleasure to declare you are now husband and wife. And David, we have a customer's
Watch me bang.
There you go, I hand you over to Eleanor.
When you come back home and all the lights are out, getting used to no one else being around. Oh, I'll be there when you need a little love, girl, a little love to share. I'm gonna come through.
So take your time, check everything through, and then make sure you're absolutely happy.
I'm sorry. Well, he's trying to check, see if I'm going to hear me.
Paula and Dave, congratulations. Brilliant. Paula, you finally got him. There we go.
He's just been let out of the asylum about 6 months ago. So he's getting there, but slowly.
Now time for the speeches. Would you please give a big warm welcome and a big clap to our first speech makers, the bride and groom.
You got a photo there?
Yeah.
I'm only saying a bit, you got to speak next. Well, I'd just like to say thank you for everybody who's coming, who's come today. Brilliant. Yeah. And opened your presents yet, so I'll probably not speak to you tomorrow when I've done that. But that's it really, just have a great night and a bit of culture club on later, dance, two cookies, I'll be saying. You know, and that's about it. Thanks very much, and I'll pass you over to Mrs. Reed. And that's it.
You had to wait for the best, obviously. Right, obviously, thank you ever so much for coming. As you all know, I've been a nightmare, yes. Long time coming, unfortunately, obviously my dad's not here, but hey-ho, cheers, bless him. I wouldn't have done it with quite a few people, to be honest, around me. Everyone's been fantastic. I've been a nightmare, but they've all been bloody great, so thank you. Yeah. So, now he's my husband, he'll do as he's told. Wow, really. Yeah, I know. 11 years today since our first date. That's how long it's took. Yeah. We should be in the Sugar Brook now getting drunk after he took me to Stairport. Chav, but hey ho. But yeah, so, but it's all been worth it, innit?
Yeah.
Yeah. Right then, so we've got some presents, obviously, because everyone's been fantastic. I hope I haven't missed anybody. If I have, I do apologise in advance. So if you could, like, come up when I shout out your name, please. So the first one is... Mum.
You can take it over to your mum. John, come and get it.
No, she can come and get it. She'll get a photo picture. There you go, Mum. Just a little something to say thank you for everything.
Top.
Lisa, where's she gone?
Sorry.
Next one. Charlie. Thank you very much. There you go, darling.
Thanks for
thank you. Amanda, here she comes. There we go, my lovely.
Thank you.
Thank you. Uncle John. Just because you ain't doing a speech, you ain't getting out of having coming up and getting a present. Trinity. There you go, darling.
Melanie.
Oh, well, I'll let you off then. You got an excuse. Right then. Stanley. There you go, mate. Thank you. Eli, come to Nanny. Come to Nanny. Come on, come to Nanny. It's all right. You take your time.
Yeah, double mate.
Thanks. Don't drop it, for God's sake, it's breakable. Henry. There you go, darling.
No worries, mate.
Arthur. No, he ain't going to come up, is he?
No.
Oh, he is. Watch out, watch out. There you go, darling. Thank you. Helen. Grace. It's a nightmare, isn't it? There you go, darling. Thank you.
That one, that one.
Who have we got? Stuart, please. There you go, Doc. Thank you very much. And this is just for some random person, for Alan. Yeah, there you go.
That's it,
was that it?
Yeah. That's it.
There you go, Doug. So thank you, everyone. Hope you have a great day, a great night, and raise a drink to whoever, absent friends, people that can't be here, and everyone that's here. Cheers. Love you all. Thank you.
This will only take an hour. I hope you've all got a drink because it's a long speech.
How long are we going to understand you? That's the main thing.
Yeah, no, you wouldn't. You heathens from Bromsgrove wouldn't understand a bloke like me. What have I done with my speech? I have. Three times today, I haven't put that in the wrong pocket. Right, afternoon, ladies and gents. Anybody that doesn't know me, I'm Alan. I'm the best man. Don't you know it? Yeah, that's it. I ain't got no more. Yeah, I've known Dave about 40 years now, isn't it, mate? We met Aston Fields Working Men's Club, playing snooker rather badly, as Stu and Jiff will tell you.
I used to win the money.
You had, you're right, Jiff, yeah, because you cheated. Although, I hope you all agree, it's been what a beautiful ceremony it was. I really like the part where Dave said, I do. Yeah. And Paula said, you better. All right, where else are Dave? Handsome, funny, smart. Yeah. Sorry, mate, I can't read your item. What do you want down there? Yeah. All right, Dave, you'll leave here today with a wonderful wife, beautiful, funny, very generous. Paula, you'll leave with a new dress and a nice bunch of flowers. Well, I think that's enough said, isn't it, really? Right. On behalf of the bridesmaids, Page Boys and myself, I'd like to thank you both for the wonderful presents. And that's about it, really. And so to the toast. I think I can speak for everyone who'd say, we wish you all the happiness you deserve. We're so glad you have found each other. And this day is a reminder that the best is yet to come. So can I ask everyone to raise their glasses to the happy couple.
Cheers.
Cheers. Glad that's over.
Clear the table.
Oh, yes, sorry. They have asked me to say, once now the speech is over, can you all go vacate on the tables? Because they want to set the dance floor up.
Yes.
So, you can all go home, come back in half hour.
Where's the strippers?
Later, Jeff. On the Benson Castle.
Can you see the bleeding? He's alive, look at it.
And he took me to Starport for our first date today, 11 years ago. And I said, I thought we was going to Stratford. He said, but if we did like each other, it's too far to come home. So that was it. I had a playman's, you had a ham sandwich.
Said the angel pork.
Yeah. Hold out for tomorrow, swimming deepest rivers, giving then we borrow. Everyone's a winner. Things are looking up, but we'll never touch the ground. I'm better than I've been as long as I get you. Captive to the sound of, oh, oh, honey, don't you let go of me. Oh, oh, honey, this love is wild and free. Of your voice, all the unexpected joys, elevating off your smile, laughing with me like a child. Every minute is a light, showing us there's more to life. Open hands, arms open wide, choosing to endure the ride. Things are looking up, but we'll never touch the ground. I'm better than I've been as long as I got you around. Our lives, they open up. Captive to the sound of, oh, oh, honey, don't you let go of me. Oh, oh, honey, this love is wide and free.
I've enjoyed today because the food has been amazing and we are now ready for the disco and I am really excited for dancing around with everyone.
And show me some of the dance moves you're going to do for the disco. Can you do the floss?
Shall I show you my dance moves that I'm going to do?
Yeah, go on then.
Yeah,
I've enjoyed today because the food's been
nice.
Lovely.
To see David finally married.
It's been fantastic.
All the best
to the bride. And it's been fantastic to have a piggy bank. And these are going to be my dance moves for a disco.
Okay, hi love, it's your mother, and I've got to admit, it's been a fantastic day, absolutely brilliant, and everybody has commented about everything, and I can't be any happier than where I am at this precise moment. I love you both.
Thank you so much, babe, for a beautiful day, couldn't have been any better. I know I got emotional, but that was only because of Dad. But it's been amazing. You deserve every bit of happiness you've got. I love you.
Really enjoyed today. It's been a lovely day. It's been amazing. Paul and Dave, wish you all the best, and I love you both very much.
We've had a really happy time. Very happy time. It's the best wedding I've been to, actually. I've got brother-in-laws and nieces. It's not much good, but we've managed to cope today. It's
been a brilliant day. Thank you, Dave and Paula, for inviting us all. And I hope you have many, many happy years together. Next, you want to say something?
Hi Dave and Paul, I hope you have a brilliant, brilliant day. It's been absolutely fabulous. Love you to bits, see you soon.
And I could get some sleep tonight.
Cake cut, so that's lovely.
A life that's full. I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my way.
That's the first chorus, right? They're feeling ever so lonely. So ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, would you now join your bride and groom? Come on, please. Come and help them out. They're feeling a bit lonely up here. So come on, everybody, come and join them, help them out. Come on, everybody. That's the way. Come on up. And you can help them with singing as well. That'd be great. So come on. Come on, everybody. To the dance floor.
I planned each charted course. each careful step on the byway. More,
that's it. Come on, get your honors. Here we go. Come
more
on.
Than this,
you know the words.
I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit on more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way.
Oh, lovely singing.
My fill, my share of losing, and now as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way.
Come on, folks, sing it for your bride and groom. Come on. Here we go.
For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not to say the things he truly feels.
Come on, folks. One more time. Together, bride and groom first dance. How about that? Right, they're gonna stay on the dance floor. So are you. We're gonna have one more slow. Come on, then. Everybody in, please. Room for one or two more. Come on, then, to the dance floor. Let's have you up and come and join them on the dance floor. Come on, room for you, friends and family. Up you come. Come on.